Hi, folks. We really have a special program for you. I don't think I've ever used the word legendary in any of my TV shows. Today I'm going to. This program is about the legendary Elhew Pointer bloodline and his founder, Bob Whaley. Bob worked these dogs and developed these dogs beginning back in the 1930s. And probably it was the most well-known bloodline for pointing dogs in the world for many, many years. Bob died in 2002, and he passed that bloodline on to Brian Hayes at Chokeboard Kennel in Rhode Island. Brian worked that line and continued to develop that line for many years. Brian passed away recently, and that line is now in the hands of Mel Feifel at Hampshire Kennels. And Mel knew Bob Whaley very well, and Mel knew also Brian Hayes very well. So she was a great candidate to receive this bloodline and continue the reputation that Bob Whaley developed and worked at hard for so many years. We're gonna visit with Mel at Hampshire Kennels. We're gonna be doing a lot of interviewing with her. So we'll do some cutaways to keep it interesting. But this is a great, great video on the present status of the Elhew bloodline. Enjoy.
Bird Dogs Afield, presented by Native Performance Dog Food, providing performance diets for the canine athlete, and brought to you in part by RST, manufacturers of short chamber, low pressure shot shells. Mud River Dog Products, fundamentally changing the expectations of the hunter and dog enthusiast. Pete Shoe Dryer, inventor of the footwear dryer, take on the nuisance of foot odor. Wooden Stream, outdoor footwear outfitting adventures since 1957. Visit woodenstream.com for a dealer near you. Canine Active, providing safe, non-toxic pain relief for your dog.
Well, folks, we're really happy today to be with Mel Feifel from Hampshire Kennels. And Mel, welcome to Bird Dogs Afield.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Mel has quite a history in this business, in both pointers and labs. And we love her kennel. We're going to go out. We're going to see some dogs. But Mel, you know I want to get to the Bob Whaley subject, and you knew him a long time ago, right? I mean, this wasn't a late in life, or
tell it was a later in life with my dog breeding. I started breeding Labradors in 1971 and started importing Labradors and showing, and we won the national in 1985 with the first chocolate to ever do it, and then went on and brought in some English champions, and they really were a lot of the foundation stock for current dogs today that are popular in Labradors. What intrigued me or brought me to Bob is that I grew up in a hunting and fishing environment and started hunting over here with some Elhew pointers. And then got intrigued enough that my husband and I were over in the Henderson area for business, and actually had been trying to buy a pointer, I'll go back a little bit, from Bob for 2 years, and just got very little response. So anyways, we were over there, and we stopped in to see him, and I sort of beat a dog out of him that he was a two-year-old dog, and his name was Elhew Seawolf. And Bob, he was a littermate to Elhew Magoo. And Bob really didn't need him, but he wanted him, and he had registered him with the AKC, thinking that maybe he'd show him also. And anyways, I convinced him that he didn't need him, and we brought him home. And a little sidebar to the story is Bob said, oh yeah, he's totally broke. And I said, oh, well, that's great. What are some of his, what do I need to key him on? And He said, well, whistle twice and you'll release him. So can remember he got off the airplane. I had him up in the middle of the driveway and I said, you want to see this dog? And a bunch of people were watching and I whistled him twice and the dog took off like a rocket ship. And I said, oh, there's one thing missing here. I never asked him how you get him back. So that went on, you know, things got better. And then with the same dog, we were hunting down in Alabama at Westervelt and had him down there. And I had just a fabulous day. That was the, maybe I got him in the fall and it was the first winter. And I called Bob that night and said, oh my God, you did such a great job training this dog. He was just fabulous. Everybody thought he was the best thing and went on and on about it. And he very quietly over the phone, as only he could do, said, aren't genetics great? Meaning the dog had never been trained.
Oh,
so it was
goodness.
Just all wow. natural instinct
yeah.
in
yeah.
his breeding program.
A quick message from our sponsors, and we'll be right back to more with Mel Feifel and the Elhew Bloodline at Hampshire Kennels.
Hi, folks. Our dogs work very hard for us. They need and deserve a high-performance dog food. My choice is Native. Native has been formulated for the canine athlete. It has none of the low-value, hard-to-digest fillers such as soy, corn, wheat. It has only high-grade chicken and high-grade digestible grains. It comes in four levels of fat and protein. Each level is formulated for the stress and activity level for your dog at that time. Make the switch today. Your dog will be happy, and so will you.
Hi, Bird Dogs Afield viewers. I'm here today with Dylan, who's almost 10 years old and still hunting hard. So in order to help him, we use Canine Active. It's for working and hunting breeds, and it is my go-to for pain relief and for an anti-inflammatory. You can use it before strenuous activity to help keep them moving and help reduce muscle soreness, or you can use it after for recovery. Try it today, Canine Active.
This pointer is coming on 11 years old. He's out of two field trial champions, a woodcock champion and a grouse champion. And some of Bob Whaley's nice old dogs.
Wonderful.
Lee.
Well,
he's
a good looking dog, that's for sure.
He's got this figured out.
He knows we're up to something.
Got a lot of points.
Yeah, we've got a lot of birds here and a lot of scent around, but we've got an awful nice point here. Did you say 11 years old, Mel?
Yes.
Wow.
Out of two field trial champions.
Huh. Very, very nice. Very nice, Mel. That's pretty classic pointer. So, Mel, how many Elhew dogs do you have right now, Elhew pointers?
I have probably about 12.
About 12.
Which is a fairly small breeding program.
Yeah.
You know, it's enough so the dogs are well socialized, and I have a gene pool of dogs and can breed within the kennel and outside the kennel. Mm-hmm. But I only, I stay right with the Elhew lines.
Sure.
So
well, I don't blame you. Yeah. Does Martha still have any dogs?
She has a few pets down there, when Brian got sick, there are three up here, mm-hmm. and that's about it. So, mm-hmm. but she has the availability to use some of their stud dogs. So, it is great. It was obviously their Snakefoot frozen semen that we just used. Mm-hmm. And if we're so fortunate to get puppies, that will add we'll bring some older pedigrees up front again. And We're very excited about doing that. So once the two, you'll see in a while or however you put this video together, that when we look at the puppies, there are two or three frozen semen litters here this year. And basically that's about protecting the pedigrees. Mm-hmm. So that in doing that, then we can go forward with in the family of Elhew dogs and have enough combinations that we feel comfortable breeding for a number of years.
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, that's very, very exciting. And
it is for me.
And as you know, I filmed one of your pups with Greg Doherty here last week, and we're gonna show that dog here in just a little bit. And that looked awful good to me. And it appears to me that using people like Greg, that maybe some of the dogs might get back into field trials, you think, or not?
I think there's a need to prove that they can right now.
Yeah.
It's a question of putting them in the right places. I've narrowed it down. We had dogs out west in horseback shooting trials, and I've narrowed it down that I want to stay in the grouse woods where I hunt.
Yeah.
And also have the trainers close by so you can get easy access to them and really know what's going on with the dogs. And certainly Craig is in a great wild bird habitat.
Definitely.
And so at the very least, I'm going to get a good woodcock grouse dog.
Sure.
And hopefully we'll have something that we can find to run. The current dog he started with, she's a real off-season dog and presents a problem because she can't be in, you know, she... She's just right now, she's about 25 days past Derby age.
Derby, yeah.
And has to run in open, and we got to qualify her. And there's logistically some issues with that.
Yeah.
Whether that will happen or not, we'll see. And this week, she's getting traded out for two younger dogs that he's going to evaluate, and then we'll figure out what goes down south with him.
Good.
So,
good.
Break with,
all right.
He just. All right,
oh,
want to send in the...
What a nice point. Nice find.
Lee, whoa. Now, the lab mooch is on his, on the pointer's find, and he'll check right, usually he'll wipe right under his nose. Has he got him?
Whoa!
Whoa.
So Mel, if I ask you what Bob Whaley looked for in his breeding, what he was striving to obtain, what would you say?
I would say perfection in every way.
Yeah.
And he was probably, as he got older, getting impatient to get there, and so his idea, he always brought in a well-qualified outcross that was proven with in production and in the field.
Yeah.
And as he aged, I think he wanted to breed closer and closer, because that's where you get the truest dogs. When people talk about outcrossing, and really in my book, outcrossing is the most dangerous thing you can do dog breeding, because you don't know the five or six generations behind them.
Yeah.
And so by Bob looking for perfection, he would go, if you're... your breeding stock is healthy and free of genetic problems, you can hopefully keep line breeding or inbreeding and increasing the chance of getting what you're looking for.
Right. Good.
Very this good. Is the mama of the puppies, Elhew Zeta Jones. We call her Catherine.
Mel, that's pretty stylish there. I like that a lot.
She's a very nice, not only a great mother, but a really well put together pointer.
She's how old?
She is 3.5.
3.5? Wow. Look at that.
And I would say she was Brian Hayes' pride and joy before he got really sick. He was happy to have produced her.
And she's out of?
She is out of a dog called Elhew Boston Patriot. And he is out of Champion Elhew Explorer, Lee's dad. And a female that Brian had out of Seawolf daughter, Tomboy, Seawolf combination.
Wow. That is style. That's what you're looking for in a pointer right there. That's as good as it gets. So, Mel, tell me how old these dogs are.
The dog with his lip curled is an Elhew Distinction Son, and he's 3 and is pretty broke. He was out at Pine Ridge, and this young dog is 16 months.
A quick message from our sponsors, and we'll be right back to more with Mel Feifel and the Elhew Bloodline at Hampshire Kennels.
Hi, friends. You know, whether you're a hiker, hunter, jogger, walker, all of those activities create sweat and moisture in your footwear. That moisture leads to bacteria, mildew, mold, all bad things for your feet. To eliminate that moisture, you need a peat shoe dryer. The new PowerCell Peat eliminates that moisture and creates a better atmosphere for good foot health.
I'm wearing the new Maniac boot from Wooden Stream. Hunting boots, more like athletic footwear for hunters. At just over 2 pounds, this may be the lightest hunting boot ever.
More important, Maniac's free-floating lace system connects to the sole, so when you lace up, the boots conform to your feet.
This dramatically reduces boot slop, toe jam, and heel lift, meaning virtually no hot spots, blisters, or sore feet.
Maniac, try one on at your local Wooden Stream dealer.
And you also were helped Bob a little bit with some litters, didn't you? Kind of a satellite kennel for him.
Well, yeah, he had at various times after I met him, he had had some illness and heart problems, and off and on as he got older. And at that one period in time, he had checked me out pretty heavily because many of his friends, he was a great friend of Tom Bradley, who runs the American Kennel Club Westminster show. Mm-hmm. And Tom said, this gal has done a lot in Labradors and really is, you know, a credible person. I think that's how this whole thing started, was through Tom. And Bob had been having trouble having puppies. And, of course, we had already in Labradors gotten into using chilled and frozen semen and artificially inseminating females. So very not many bird hunters were even thinking along those lines. And so I brought, I think, 8 females home, and they were really his best females in the kennel, a little bit older, but had not had litters for a couple of years. And we ended up getting all of them bred, and I think I had that winter 54 puppies.
Oh my!
So
goodness,
it
puppies.
Was many more than I ever expected. And that spring, drove them over when Bob got home from Midway, and so he could pick what he wanted, and hopefully he would be taking many of those puppies, and got over there after a long trip. I think, I don't know if it's 8 or 9 hours to Henderson, but it was a long trip with 54 puppies, I can tell you that. And we let all that, you know, went through the puppies, and he ended up taking two and sent me home with 52 puppies. And I said to him, Bob, now what am I going to do? I don't have a market for these dogs. This is your deal. How am I going to get rid of 52 puppies here? The bad part was the 52 puppies. The good part was I got to see his best females produce some really super, super puppies and really start to learn the bloodline. So that worked out well.
Good. Now, when the bloodline went down to Brian Hayes at Choke Boar Kennel, you continued to stay in touch with Brian and remained good friends with him.
Yeah, he had... my group of dogs was a little bit different from his group of dogs because if you fast forward it a little bit, he had Bob's most modern dogs or his most recent breeding program. Yeah. And it was a very much different than what I had been breeding. So I continued and field trialing. And so Brian continued along with those pedigrees, and I continued along with the early pedigrees that I'd started with and really stuck pretty close to those. And the good thing about it is both of us had some really nice dogs, and now it allows us to go forward with mixing these two. They're not different bloodlines, but there's enough different blood that we can go on for a long time breeding these Elhew pointers without getting into trouble. So
wonderful. And you have basically all the Brian Hayes Elhew stock now.
Yes, we have some of his younger stock, and at the same time, what we're doing this year is really going back to frozen semen litters, and then we'll go forward with those puppies in breeding. So we've taken some of Brian had some Snakefoot frozen semen. I had some Champion Elhew Explorer frozen semen. That was a litter we did. Both of the Snakefoot female is going in to be x-rayed on Tuesday, and hopefully we have
a snakefoot litter.
Baby or two.
Oh, wow.
So I think that is really exciting, yeah. And it's really, really fun to see, to go back to the traits that these dogs had, and you can pick up any of those Explorer puppies and see their dad. You can see how he threw his feet forward and sort of hugged you. The pointers are distinctive because they sort of wrap themselves around you, and it's really fun to be doing this, and I wish I could place a million of them because there's a lot more pedigrees I'd like to do.
Yeah, great. Well, Mel, I want to thank you so much. You've been a great host for us, and we've enjoyed our visit. We're going to go out and look at some dogs, and I just appreciate your time very much.
Well, it's fun to have you here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming to the kennel.
Now we're going to look at some puppies.
Nice looking litter of puppies here. How many you got?
Well, there were 13. One's left for its home. So there are 12, 9 girls, and 4 boys.
And what's the breeding?
The breeding is Catherine, who is Elhew Zeta Jones, who we just had on camera a little while ago, and Grouse Champion Elhew Explorer.
Wow. Oh, there you are, handsome puppies. Wow. I think there's a field champion in here somewhere.
I think there's some nice puppies.
Wow, I think so.
It's a pretty amazing litter.
Yeah.
Hey, little girl. Hey, little girl.
Oh, yeah.
What you doing? What are you doing? It's a she.
They've discovered birds. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
Let's see if she can find this other one. All right, baby. All right, up. Up. Yeah, I guess she can. Whoa. Whoa. Let me just get in front of her first so that she'll stay put. Whoa. And I don't think, whoa. Gilly, whoa. 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 She puts her head, nose up in the air like that. I think, you know, you ever smell anything and you raise your head? That's what she does. She loves to crank her head up. But in my mind, she's the perfectly conformed pointer. She's relatively short coupled. She's got plenty of leg under her, nice bone structure. And she loves to point. And you see that little, just little bit of a kink in her tail? That's because her feet aren't on level ground. If she was on level ground, it would be just perfectly straight up. And she's not, she won't be two till December, so she's pretty well broke for a young dog. Here we go.
And what, has she been in trials?
No. Whoa. I got her this winter and took her to Kentucky, and she wasn't ready for the Kentucky trials. And she's an off-age dog, which means she's going to be a shooting dog this fall, so... we'll have to, you know, she's only a month older than the oldest of this year's derbies, but she's going to have to run against the big dog, so we'll see how she does. But I'm going to let the bird go just to give her a chance to relax a little bit. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Good girl, good girl. But like all the Elhew dogs, she's been real easy to break, real easy to handle. She still runs plenty. And we were out in the woods the other day. She was out over a couple hundred yards. Starting to do well on her wild birds.
And what's her name again?
Her call name is Dilly. Her registered name is Elhew See Me Run. But C is spelt S-E-A because her father was Elhew Seaman. And Mel Feifel had a lot of dogs, Sea Coral, Sea Captain, Seaman, so she's kind of continuing that little twist on naming.
Hi folks, I hope you enjoyed that updated status of the Elhew bloodline. It's a great line, historic line, legendary line, and I hope you enjoyed that. I want to mention to our online viewers, there's an addendum to this. We have an interview with Greg Doherty. He's currently training See Me Run, Elhew See Me Run, kennel named Dilly, and you saw that dog in the video. So watch for that. It's the interview with Greg Doherty, and that'll be online on our website. Thanks, folks. Hope to see you in the field someday.
Bird Dogs Afield, presented by Native Performance Dog Food, and brought to you in part by RST Shot Shells, Mud River Dog Products, Peach Shoe Dryer, Wooden Stream Outdoor Footwear, and Canine Active.